Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. The Washington Capitals, New York Rangers on a Saturday night leading up to New Year's Eve. Ryan Hallwick, okay, he's on ice. He's ready to go.
Yeah, nice to see him back in the lineup, and this was close. This was last night. Watch Schubert kick out his right leg. That's Christoph Schubert of Ottawa. Kicked out his right leg, and then later on did something similar. And Hallwick, thank God it wasn't a knee. It was more of a Charlie horse, a thigh bruise. And he said before the game, he said, it's not going to get any worse, so I'm going to play. But it's certainly not 100%. It's tight, but he doesn't want to get out of the lineup, so he's in. That's a good thing.
And the Washington Capitals, flu-ridden. Lots of people out of their lineup. Brent Johnson, their goalie, out with the flu. Brian Sutherby as well. Tonight's New York Ranger high-definition broadcast presented by Panasonic Ideas for Life. And we are underway. The two have split the first two games played. And a quick shot taken by Ovechkin in on Lundqvist. He kicks it aside.
Took him 15 seconds to get the first shot of the game.
200 shots, 201 now. He leads the league in shots on goal. He's got 25 goals, 24 assists. Is coming off that Calder Trophy season of last year, 52 goals, 54 assists.
You know, Mike, he leads the league in shots, as you mentioned, and he's not a selfish player. He's just got that kind of ability to beat you one-on-one, to take the shot while he's moving. He's some kind of talent.
Interesting conversation Al Troutwig had with Marty Straka prior to the game about his little drought and the rest of the team, and Marty said it's way too early to panic. 43 games remaining, but on the other hand, Brendan Shanahan said, let's get a win. It's desperation time for us.
Well, when you don't, it just keeps dragging on, and people keep talking about it, and the pressure keeps mounting, and you just, once you get it, then it's over, and then you can start again.
Yeah, the Rangers have had 4-1 goal losses in the last five, and that 2-0 shutout on Long Island. So things just haven't bounced their way, and they haven't played well enough either. So they hope to turn it around tonight at home, where they are 7-7-3 on the season. Here's Nylander. Now feeds Shanahan, intercepted by Ovechkin. A turnover. Big hit there.
Ovechkin's still on the ice. He's been on the ice almost 2 minutes.
Out from behind the net and back out to Kasparaitis. Tried to tee it up. Pruka on ice now, along with Nylander, Shanahan. And the feed. Big shot. Saved by Kolzik, and a goal! The rebound goes in. It's Peter Pruka, and the Rangers lead early 1-0. And that's the way to get it started.
Get the puck to the net, get players to the net, and you never know what'll happen. A huge hit by Ovechkin. And then the shot from the point. And he watched the hit coming up right there. Nylander, Ovechkin. Then the shot by Rakunik, nice and low, so that there's a rebound. There's a hit just prior to that, and Ovechkin was mad. And then the nice, hard, low shot, and the Rangers going to the net. And Pruka with the rebound, 1-0. What a way to start.
Peter Pruka had success against the Capitals in the five games he has played professionally. That's his third goal. He's had two assists in the six games played against them now.
The shutout streak is over.
Do the math, Joe. I think it's 153 minutes plus the Rangers hadn't scored. Now moving in, and a shot blocked by the defense. A little wrister deflected before it got to Lundqvist. Back behind the Rangers net, Matt Pettinger. He's moving in Shanahan with a check.
He's back in the lineup. He was one of the players with the flu that didn't play last night in New Jersey. So he is back in there. Brian Sutherby is a good player for them as well. Out again because of the flu. They hope he could play.
And lots of physical play behind the net. Capitals come up with it. And back to the point it goes. As Aaron Ward in to do some checking, and the Rangers able to take it away. Washington also playing without Richard Zetnik. He's out with a groin injury. 13 games he's missed already. Matt Bradley, their left wing, a hand injury, 10 games. John Erck's got a foot fracture. Brian Muir, another defenseman, in a foot fracture. Puck is loose in front for the moment. The Rangers come up with it. They're firing shots on Kolzik quickly and early here and he gloves it to get the whistle.
Now, Ovechkin, as we talked about, he got mad because Kasparaitis nailed him. And then he got up, and he loves to hit anyway. And he sees an opportunity. He goes right after Nylander, but the shot came through. Nylander looked up at Ovechkin and said, you know what, I'll take the hit for the goal. We haven't had one in almost three games. Hit me again.
hit me every time if we can score. There it is, 153 minutes, 38 seconds. The Rangers had not scored a goal. Well, they get going early in the first 2 minutes here. Rakunic, with that big slap shot, set it up. Nylander gets an assist as well on Puka's seventh of the season.
Now the Rangers have to be smart and just keep going. This is a Washington Capitals team that, despite the flu, and this is one of the hardest working teams in the league, and they will not quit. They'll just keep coming at you. They've got some good young players that we mentioned, Ovechkin. Semin's having a terrific player, another young Russian, a terrific year. And so they're going to keep coming hard, and the Rangers have to keep up this momentum and keep the pressure on.
Now, they have scored 117 goals as a team. They've given up, though, 133. That's been part of the issue lately for them as they've dropped 5 of 6. Wrister knocked down by the defense, and here's Ovechkin nearly on a breakaway.
What a play by Polk. What a big-time play. He looked over to his right and said, uh-oh, number 8's over there, and he's not supposed to be there, and I'm supposed to be over in a different place, and he reacted and made a good play, and then Ovechkin with another big hit.
Huge collision with Michael Roosevelt near the blue line, and the Rangers come up with it. Chipped ahead by Fetter Tootin, but back to retrieve.
Mike, I think Ovechkin was on the ice for the first 2 minutes of the game. He was out there when the goal was scored. I don't think he came off the ice. I believe that he stayed out there. He started the game up front and was out there, I think, for the first 2 minutes.
Well, he's a young man. He's got plenty of energy, but that is a long time to be on ice.
That's
to start
a long shift, no matter how young you are.
Here is Matt Cullen doing a nice job as the Rangers able to clear the zone. We're just underway, 5 minutes plus. The Rangers with a 1-0 lead on a Peter Pruka goal. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti with you. Glad you could join us this Saturday night. Bouncing puck in on Kolzik. Kolzik with 21 wins in his career against the Rangers, 17 losses. Into the shot! Oh, Shanahan denied!
Big time save there. Olaf Kolzik has played a lot of minutes and has faced a lot of shots. They give up almost 35 shots a game on average. And that was a big-time save on Shanahan.
Up the right wing, Boyd Gordon, 23-year-old, 17th overall pick in 2002. Another big hit behind the net, and the Rangers out with it. Skating hard up the right wing. Puck wrapped around the boards and out.
Mike, you know it's very apparent here to start the game. We played a little over 6 minutes. But it's worth noting, the Rangers are playing a north-south game. It means they're getting to the blue line. If the play's not there, they're getting the puck in, and they're going. You know, they're going forechecking after it. They're shooting the puck at the net. They're trying to get there instead of stopping at the blue line, twirling back, you know, doing that type of play. They just keep going. They take an icing here. But we'll take a timeout with the Rangers leading 1-0. Here's a look at our Panasonic digital replay. The Rangers leading this game 1-0, and Ovechkin nearly got a breakaway there, and that was where Thomas Polk released Somme, came over, got his stick in the right position, and Ovechkin has been all over the ice. That's a big hit on Roosevelt, and then Shanahan takes the pass from Cullen from behind the net, and Kolzig with a very good stop there, and then more hitting down the other end. Rakunic on Gordon, who tried to slow down and stop, and the momentum of both players knocked Gordon down, and so the Rangers face off in their own zone.
6.5 minutes in, the Rangers with a 1-0 lead. Four of their last five losses have been one-goal games. And they're trying to snap out of it here, having fallen to the ninth in the East over this most recent stretch.
Mike, I mentioned I thought maybe Ovechkin was on the ice the first full 2 minutes. He wasn't. He started, went off the ice, very quick rest for him, came right back on the ice, and then was on when the Rangers scored their goal, and there he is again. Remember, this Washington team's got some flu that's going through them, so Ovechkin, I'm sure, is going to try and play 60 minutes. 58.
The Rangers hockey brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver. We were talking earlier on the way up to Chris Clark, who said it just struck overnight almost, the team, and Glenn Hanlon mentioned it as well. the flu bug that had hit the Rangers last week.
Rangers can relate. Actually, a few weeks ago, and then Rangers had just lingered.
Loose puck played back to center. Betts has it. Adam Hall now. He flips it ahead and gives chase, and a huge hit there by Hallwig. Coming off that Charlie horse, showing no ill effects right now. Back to center it goes, and Tootin to retrieve.
Mike, I hate to sound inhumane, but you know, when a team's suffering from the flu and they're fatigued, the way to play them is aggressive and physical.
I don't think you're
mean,
inhumane.
Huh?
No, you're not mean-spirited. Not that I know of. Certainly not in 2006. The Rangers at home here trying to regain some momentum. That's Roosevelt giving chase on the far side. Now Jágr, who taking his captaincy seriously, moves in on the left wing. Now changes up, leaves for Nylander. Polk got a shot in, almost to the net. And now Straka. Near side, it's Nylander. Nifty stick work there. And Nylander working the perimeter. Penalty coming up. Roosevelt fired a shot across the goal crease. Back to the point where Straka stands. Now Marty moves in. Back pass Jágr, but out of the zone. Out of the net is Lundqvist. Roosevelt headed to the bench. Might be in some pain. Have to check on that. And it's Nylander. Extra skater on. And finally, the Caps break it up, and the power play will begin for the Rangers.
Yeah, the penalty happened in deep. Nylander right there, and there you see the stick up in the waist area. That's by Clark. Here it comes again, right in here. And so Clark will get the penalty for hooking. And then Hallwig, he's fine, isn't he? That's just, you know, it's a right play. Dump the puck in slow. And then going to get it, Donald Brashear, we know, is a tough physical player. He goes in and gets a hit on Roosevelt. So the Rangers get the first power play of the game, leading 1-0.
Brashear's been there 15 years doing the same thing. This power play, powered by AMD, smarter choice. And Clark in the box for hooking. Clark, a kid from South Windsor, Connecticut. There's number 17. So the Ranger power play, which has struggled mightily, just 11% over this losing streak. 4 of 37 gets a chance to go to work. And they're offside here to start. Well, Jaromír Jágr feeling the responsibility quite a bit for what's been happening with the Rangers lately.
Yeah, I mean, you see what he says. This was last night. John Delapina from the Daily News waited and interviewed Jágr, who was late to come out of the room last night. I'm not going to hide. I have to do it. When I don't play good, the team doesn't play good. I'm not sure I totally agree with that. But the point being is that he feels very responsible for this team being in this seven-game losing streak and takes a lot of it personally. And remembers it is a team game. There's other players as well. But with the kind of year he had last year, with the expectations that he has on himself, with the expectations, I think, that the fans and his teammates and everybody else, he just shoulders a lot of that responsibility and feels that he hasn't been living up to his end.
Well, the Rangers 1 of 7 against the Caps this season on the power play, just over 14%. And well, Jágr keeps his smile, he keeps his sense of humor, but you can
sometimes
sense, yeah, the weight can really hang on your best player.
He didn't have a sense of humor last night, I'll tell you that. During the game, you could tell he was very frustrated, just in his actions on the bench and on the ice, the way he looked. Full of frustration, and after the game, he didn't want to really talk to anybody, but John Delapina was very patient in waiting him out.
Along the near side boards, Jágr comes up with it, feeds Roosevelt, and cleared out of the zone by Washington.
Yeah, this is Washington, has very similar penalty killers to Ottawa. Very aggressive.
Straka moving in. Centers. Shanahan there. And a skate save made by Kolzig.
I think he made the save on Nylander. Shanahan tried to get the shot, but they defended him, and Nylander went in, I think, found the loose puck and got the shot.
Great pass that time by Nylander, but Jágr was steaming in offside.
Shanahan doesn't like the call. He thinks that it was not an offside, so the faceoff will come outside. Now, just prior to this, Straka tries to find Shanahan. And then I think it was Nylander that got a piece of it, and Kolzig had to make the save.
Well, both Shanahan and he were right there.
Yeah, if it wasn't Shanahan, it was Nylander, but in either event, good save by Ole the goalie.
Rangers showing some good energy to start here, though. Here's Prucka, the goal scorer, sends ahead, deflected wide. The clearing attempt doesn't work. Rakunic sets up, shot blocked down by the defense.
I like what the Rangers are doing, though. They're decisive. They're attempting to take the shots and get the puck to the net.
Here's Betts. Try to wrap it in. And a rebound effort. Kolzig stops it with 10 seconds left on the power play.
Now, that's one thing that's really different with this number two power play unit that's on the ice. They don't waste much time. They take it to the net. They get shots. They don't overpass. They just try to get it there. And you can see all three players just attacking the net. Betts tries to stuff it in. You've got Prucka that goes there. Cullen that goes to the net. Just prior to that, we saw the defense try to set up for the one-time shot to get the puck through.
Midway through the first, the faceoff one back to the point. Here's Kasparaitis, lines it up, fires! Glove save by Kolzig. Back to the point one more time. Kasparaitis trying to flip it in toward the net. It hit Adam Hall in the chest, bounces down, and here come the Caps. And an offside there by Washington. 9:20 to go in the first. Rangers leading 1-0.
Capitals 1-0. It's been an interesting first 10 and a half minutes or so with Alexander Ovechkin. Has he ever been in the middle of things? With the puck, he's attracted the Rangers close to him. They want to stay close to him. They're trying to hit him and keep him in the defensive zone. And he also can dish it back. He loves to hit. He loves to run over people. And we saw that a couple of times. Huge hit there on Michael Postma. He's some kind of player. I mean, he's fun to watch. The kid's about 220 pounds. Is as fast as anybody in the league. Got great hands, a great shot.
Great heart.
We'll do anything.
6'2", great heart.
You know, he was asked recently, who's the toughest player in the league to play against? He said, me. And I said, no, really, besides, and he said, well, me. He said, I'd hate to play against me. You know, and they listed, you know, Jagr's difficult to play against, and, you know, but he's got that, as Al was, when Al was talking to him in our pregame show, and Al mentioned he's got that smile and that personality. I mean, the kid's, he's really something special.
He's kind of really mastered special. That one-word answer thing. Al said, how's life going? He goes, unbelievable.
Yeah. Hey, listen, he's worked hard. A couple of years, he didn't know any English. He's worked very, very hard to understand the English language and to get along with everyone.
Just 21 years old. Better toot and try to wrist a little drive in there. Shanahan breaks a play up at center. Bouncing puck to the blue line. And into Rangers ice. Here come the Caps. And Lundqvist had to make a save there on the shot from Matt Pettinger. Rister goes in, bounced all the way almost to the net. Here come the Rangers with a 3-on-2 opportunity. Cullen trying to feed Shanahan, who was moving to the center, and the Rangers have to retreat.
Now Shanahan wanted to make sure that he didn't go offside. Cullen thought that he had a chance to feed him on the fly.
Kasparaitis leads the charge across the blue line. Center play, Cullen fires, save Kolzig, rebound wide. Kolzig got a shot maybe in his first of the year.
Oh, did he ever. He had to go to his backhand and just wasn't able to get much on the shot. He was getting some pressure from behind. The Rangers are going. They're playing well here in the first period.
And a scrum in front of the Capitals bench where Glenn Hanlon, their coach, 13th in Caps history.
Now, the Capitals end up with a chance here. Never got through.
I thought it got through.
Yeah, I did too, but the puck didn't get through. And then the Rangers came back the other way. And there's Cullen with the shot. And that's Hallwig, who just can't quite get the shot. He was being bothered by Nicolet at the time, who's a former Ranger player. Back a few years ago, played 9 games with the Rangers.
Colt Moore lost his stick and gloves. He was going to tee it up with somebody. And the Capital player went to the bench. Oh, Lundqvist had to make a great play there on Ovechkin. And the puck is flipped up into the crowd. 7:42 left here in the first.
Well, Brashear and Colton Orr talking things over. I'll tell you what, Brashear made a smart play. And Orr is lucky. Orr's lucky that he didn't get called for a penalty. And he just said, I'm going to get off the ice. And here comes Ovechkin back on the ice. Orr gets off in a hurry to try and make sure that he wasn't called.
It's tough to hide from the referee when you drop your gloves and stick and then have to scoot back to the bench.
Look at them. They're just talking away.
Back to the point. Big slap shot deflected wide. It came off Timo Helbling, the Swiss defenseman. Puck jammed away behind the Ranger net. 7.5 minutes remaining in the first. Capitals have it. Rangers out shooting them 9-3 in the period. Back behind the Rangers net, Kasparaitis with some rough stuff. Puck in the crease, it's loose. Lundqvist locates it and holds on.
Yeah, this is getting interesting, this game. We talked about Washington being a hard-working team. They play with a lot of heart. Now, if you're going to beat the Capitals, you better match them, at least match them with intensity. And the Rangers have done that. They just keep coming. They're beat up because of the flu. They've got a few injuries on defense, but they just keep going hard. They just attack the net. Clark is a hard-working player. They're captain 17. Brashear, we talked about his strength. Zubras is a big, strong center iceman. And Henrik Lundqvist had to find this and does a nice job holding on.
Faceoff one back to Tomas Poeck. This Washington team is trying to have three straight months to start a season at 500 or above for the first time since 1991-92. How long it's been.
Yeah, I talked to George McPhee, who's their general manager. I talked to him before the game, and we had a conversation earlier in the season.
Nice setup by Ovechkin, but the shot broken up by Dinas Zubras.
And he said at that time, Mike, he said, if we're good, he said, we might get something.
Nylander's slap almost got through Kolzig.
He said, we might try and do a deal at the deadline. He likes his team.
Stroka sets up Nylander, who scores! And the Rangers lead 2-0. That was a thing of beauty.
You know, the Rangers have not, especially this line, have not turned back. When they're going forward, they keep going. They're not stopping in the neutral zone and circling. They're going forward, and it leads to this goal. And they just keep going. This is north-south hockey, not east-west. And they go after it. Roosevelt helps off by joining the rush. And then what a pass from Straka to Nylander, who takes the shot. Didn't look the pass, took the shot, and the Rangers have been awfully good here in the first period. Everybody is on the same page.
His first in six games, his 13th of the season. Marty Straka set it up. Michael Roosevelt got the secondary assist. And the Rangers lead 2-0, 6:20 left here in the first.
You know, Mike, they're just, if the play's not there at the blue line, they're getting it in. If the play is there, they're skating forward. They're not turning anything back, and they're using their speed and their pursuit on the puck to turn that into scoring chances.
And what it's showing is the Rangers can play this way. There's been a lot of conversation lately during the seven-game losing skid about this kind of play, and they are displaying it here in the first at home. Bouncing puck to the left of Lundqvist. Puka gives chase and a shot through a screen. Up onto the screen to stop play. 5:44 left in the first. The Rangers 2, Washington nothing.
And Ovechkin's on the ice. If he's close, you expect to get hit. He knocks down Nylander in the neutral zone, but the Rangers just keep going. And he missed on another hit. That was Roosevelt. And so the Rangers keep going, get the shot at the net, retrieve the puck. Roosevelt does, and then the beautiful pass coming up from Straka. Backhand shot. Backhand pass, I should say. Quick shot by Nylander. 2-0 Rangers.
So the faceoff comes to the left of Lundqvist. The Rangers leading with under 6 minutes to go here in the first. 16 days without a point in the standings for the Rangers. Trying to snap out of that tonight against the Washington Capitals. And right off the faceoff, a quick shot taken by Alexander Semin. As the Capitals trying to fire, and that one went wide, deflected. Chipped ahead, and Lundqvist had to make a save again on Semin.
Yeah, he's a good player. He got off to a great start this season, then got hurt, went through a very slow spell, and now he's flying. We talk about Ovechkin, but Semin's a very talented player.
Up the far side boards, here come the Caps.
Ovechkin is number 8, Semin is number 28.
And here is Ryan Pauthier, who fires it into Rangers ice. He's from New Bedford, Mass, a 29-year-old. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti with you at Madison Square Garden. Under 5 minutes left in the first. Al Trotwick there, too. Here's Shanahan's shot. Kolzig right out to cut the angle down. Now Puka has it. He's got a goal already. Shanahan again. Through a screen, and Kolzig had to make a save.
Kolzig has had to make three or four saves on Shanahan, and he's got everything behind the shot. And Kolzig has been there to stop him. Shanahan talked right before the game to Al about getting scoring chances, the importance of scoring chances. How about this for a scoring chance? Bang! And Kolzig there makes a good save and then gets another one right after that. And Semin is 28, and he's a highly, highly talented player. Handles a puck, can skate, can shoot. And he is a player to watch, because at times they'll put Semin up on the same line with Ovechkin, with Zubras in the middle, and it's a very dangerous line.
And he is relentless. He's led his team in shots on goal the last three games, a total of 22. Breaking up the play, Jason Ward in the slot there. Puck center out to the left of Lundqvist.
Colton Orr and Brashear both on the ice again, something you might want to just keep an eye
Let's
on.
Let's keep an eye on that. Could be fun. Here's Timo Helbling carrying in. He debuted against the Devils in last night's game.
Yeah, well, they've got a couple of young players in the lineup there. We mentioned the flu, but they've got some injuries on defense as well. Muir is out with a broken bone in his foot, as is John Erskine, who they really miss. He's been a big surprise, John Erskine. Played for the Islanders somewhat last year, and Dallas before that.
Never really able to establish himself in either place. Either.
They really like him. In fact, when he got hurt, the team started to lose. Very good penalty killer.
I think they have six, if I'm not mistaken, by count. Hershey Bears, who were part of that Calder Trophy team last year, championship team.
You know, at one time, Mike, that they played, it's been double figures, the number of players that played for that Hershey Bears team last year that have played up with the big team this year.
And there can't be a team in the league that's had that. That's pretty tough.
Well, there's teams like, you know, Chicago went through a lot of injuries, and teams go through these injuries, and you've got to, you know, you've got to dip down into the minor leagues for help.
So Nylander, Jágr, Straka on for the Rangers. Final 3 minutes of the first. The Rangers with a two-goal lead. Peter Prucha, Michael Nylander, the goal scorers. Here's Jágr as they try to organize a rush. Nylander back to Polk. And they're just crossing each other up right now as Roswell has to go back to retreat. Rangers have outshot Washington 13-5 in the first. Here's Straka with speed through center. Feeds the wing. It's Jágr. Double team down there. Nylander in to help. Jágr comes up with it. Now Nylander. Straka. Nylander taken down. There's a penalty coming. And Jágr lost it for the moment. And the Rangers will have a power play with 2:17 remaining in the first.
Chris Beach takes the tripping penalty, I believe. The Rangers have had the puck this whole first period. The opposite happened last night in Ottawa, but in this one, they're winning the one-on-one battles. They're getting to the puck. They're out battling Washington right now. Because of that, they're ahead 2-0, and they're drawing penalties. And the penalty will be, you'll see it coming up right in this area. As first they get the puck, and then the trip right there by number 24, Chris Beach. So the Rangers, what an opportunity. 2:17 to go in this first period. They're up 2-0, and a chance to take a 3-0 lead going into the period.
Back to the point where Tuukka fakes the shot, leaves for Rakuna, gets it back. Near side boards, it's Prucha. Plays catch with Adam Hall. Prucha to Hall. Moves to the slot, back to Tuukka. And here along the near side boards is Adam Hall. Moves in. They cycle around, and Tootin and the Rangers trying to get something going. Prucha fires! Rebounded! Loose! Wide! Cullen nearly had the third goal of the game. And the play is broken up by Steve Emminger, sent down to Lundqvist.
And now the Rangers will make a change. That unit took them a while to get a shot, but once they did and attacked the net, Cullen nearly scored.
Here's Jágr moving in. Two men come to him. He's able to give it up. Back to Roosevelt. And now the point, Nylander. Straka moving in. Sets up the shot. Roosevelt denied by Kolzig. He holds on. 1:15 left in the first. 58 seconds left in the power play.
Brendan Shanahan mentioned something to Dan Marinelli. Just prior to that, here's Pruka. Shot, rebound, Hall there. Cullen with the rebound that deflects off of Emminger, I believe. Here's Pruka again. Boy, if he could just get his confidence back, what a shot that was. That's confidence. Go to the net, get the shot off quickly. He had a couple opportunities last night. He looked like he was nervous, squeezing the stick a little bit, but he scored the goal tonight to get the Rangers going, and now seems to have some of that confidence back.
He's getting a little more ice time. He's averaging about 13 minutes a game on the season, coming off that 30-goal season. He's got 7 so far here. Roosevelt keeps it in. Shanahan there, feeds it to Jágr. Back to Jágr, and the point Roosevelt. Jágr there. As they play catch, 23 seconds left in the man advantage. Nylander moves in, doesn't shoot. Roosevelt fires, it got through. A save by Kolzig. Shanahan, far side boards. Nylander, Roosevelt doesn't tee it up. Crowd getting a little antsy. Back to Roosevelt. Penalty over, shot from the angle by Jágr wide. Kicked in by Straka. Cross ice, Jágr. Sets and shoots it up into the screen to stop play. 6.6 left in the first.
Yeah, it's a good play by David Steckel, 25, to come over to Jágr. A lot of passing and moving the puck around. And this is a good thing. Taking the shot every once in a while. Take the shot off the pass. Jágr going to the net. The puck actually deflects off the skate before it gets to Kolzig. So a faceoff with 6.6 seconds remaining in the first.
To the left of Kolzig, it's won by the Caps. Loose, it got in on goal. Kolzig had to stick it aside. And the final seconds tick off of a strong first period for the Rangers. And Tom Rennie's team trying to snap out of a 16-day slump. They lead 2-0 after one.
Yeah, they played a good first period. They were very aggressive. They went off after the Washington Capitals, a team that also played last night that has the flu and a few players out of the lineup, but it's a hard-working team. But the Rangers, they won all the battles in the first period. They played a north-south game. They kept the puck going forward. They kept the puck going to the net. They forced Olaf Kolzig, the Washington goaltender, to make a lot of big saves, and it was their best first period in a long time. Let's go down to Al's with Perry Pern.
All right, Joe. Coach, are they executing the power play the way you want them to, or should they be shooting more?
Well, certainly, I think on the power play, you always want to get as many shots as you possibly can, but I think we created 2 or 3 really good chances off this last power play, and both units that were out there created a chance, and I think that's what we're looking for, is to make sure that we've got the depth and the consistency in our power play where both units can go out there and be a threat.
Okay, I guess now you have to remind them that they've been in this position during this losing streak before.
Well, actually, I'm not sure we want to say anything about that. I think we just want to say that we want to go out and play the same kind of period in the second period. I think what's important to us is the process, how we play shift in, shift out. If we concentrate on that, we'll finish up with a great game here today.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
Back to you.
Thanks, Al. We'll be back. Our first intermission activities coming up. Al Trotwick joining Ryan Hallwig. Rangers lead 2-0 after one at the Garden. New York Rangers hockey brought to you in part by Canon, improving digital imaging at work, home, or play. Canon, image anywhere. By Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Call Geico at 1-800-947-AUTO or visit us at geico.com. By refinance.com, the authority on home refinancing. Visit www.refinance.com or call 1-800-734-REFI. And by Lexus. Find some of the best values of the year at the Lexus December to Remember sales event, now through January 2nd. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti, and Al Trotwick, who earlier called me a trivia killer.
Hey, Mike, a lot of pressure here.
Yeah.
There's a lot of pressure on
we did receive an email, Joe, as you recall in our pregame
meeting.
Wait,
this is the last trivia of 2006.
The best
last trivia of 2006.
I understand. I'm going to get to this. But the emailer said the best part about trivia is Al whining and moaning when he doesn't get the right answer.
See, I don't think
it's part of the entertainment.
I can't remember a time when Al has whined or moaned about anything.
You can't. Your memory's terrible. Adam Graves leads the Rangers with 23 goals against the Caps. Which Capitals player has the most goals against the Rangers? Peter Bondra, Mike Gartner, Robbie Carpenter, Mike Ridley. Who do you think it is? It's a multiple question, a multiple answer question.
Al, you know what's interesting up here? With Mike being up here tonight and Sam off doing football tomorrow, there's no extra table out here with books laid out all over the place, you know, and encyclopedias and the history of hockey and all that. There's nothing here. I don't know what to do.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you.
Cast your vote. They're all downstairs in the studio.
You know, I love you, Al. I'm with you all the way.
Cast your vote by text messaging A, B, C, or D to 62931. Standard text messaging rates apply from your carrier. And there's the question again. Adam Graves leads the Rangers with 23 goals against the Caps. Which Capitals player has the most goals against the Rangers?
Now, how do you spell Google?
Yeah, it's got to be Carpenter. It's got to be Bobby Carpenter.
Carpenter?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't know. He had one great season.
Those
Gartner had a lot of great seasons. Here come the Caps. They're moving right to left. Rangers in the home blue and a 2-0 lead as we begin the second period.
Right off the faceoff, you see Ovechkin took off right to the middle and had the shot. That was very similar to the goal that we showed Ovechkin scoring in our open tonight when he scored the overtime winner against Atlanta. Look what he does. I mean, this is a set play. Gets in there, gets the puck. That was almost identical to the overtime winner against Atlanta 6 seconds into overtime. And he didn't miss that one by much.
I like what Perry Pern said to Al in that intermission interview about, we're not going to say anything about what's happened before in two-goal and three-goal leads.
You know,
Let's not mention that.
Do the same thing you did in the first period. Keep working, keep skating, keep going to the net. Get the puck in deep. I'm not sure if they had any turnovers in the first period.
Steve Eminger ahead to Lawrence Nicolat. Play broken up at center. Back into the cap zone it comes. Betts in on the forecheck, and he'll head to the bench. The Rangers go for a line change. Opening minute of the second. And here, moving in, as a puck just off the stick of David Steckel. He had an opportunity waiting for him. As the Capitals coming in, losers of three in a row for their last five. Down 2-0, and a stuck play. Lundqvist hung on to the post right there to foil that. Now Straka moving in. He's got an assist. He fires. Broken up by the defense. Good work there by Brian Pothier. 29-year-old defenseman. Slap shot wide. Taken by Donald Brashear. Karam's out to center. And here's Jágr sending Nylander in with speed. Back to Jágr. Passes to Straka, broken up. It ends up in on Kolzig, and he has to make a stop.
Well, that deflected off of Pothier right into Kolzig. But again, this line, getting to the blue line and continuing to go instead of turning back. I think it's made a difference in the way the Rangers have played this game. They've been able to keep up their momentum, keep some forward pressure going.
That Cullen skating through the defense draws everybody. Cullen third on the Rangers and shots on goal. And the play cleared out to center. You know, Shanahan back there.
Cullen's due to break out one of these games. Not only one of these games, but for a period of time. He's a better offensive player than the numbers that he's put up thus far, Mike. Now he can skate. He can shoot. Granted, he's played left end, right. And there's the rush that where the puck deflected off Pothier, the defenseman, and Kolzig had to be alert. But for Matt Cullen, he's got too much offensive talent to be putting up the numbers he's putting up right now. I think he's just, you know, he's going to get through this and get better.
7 goals in 37 games for Cullen. Here's Pruko, who has one in this game. He's got 7 on the season. Kept in for the moment, but here come the Caps. Shanahan able to break it up at center, and a shot fired in on Lundqvist. Kind of surprised him for the moment.
Well, he had trouble picking it up, didn't it?
Yeah, and it came from the red line.
Hard wrist shot. I don't know if it deflected near the blue line, but he had some difficulty with it.
Oh, Kasparaitis had a steaming Cullen open, but couldn't quite connect with him, and it's an icing call. So 17-14 left here in the second. Tomorrow night, rock into 2007 with the Jammies New Year's Eve Marathon. 10 straight hours of classic performances from from some of music's biggest names. The Jimmy's New Year's Eve Marathon tomorrow night starting at 8, only on MSG.
Rangers need to get out of this situation. That line's tired. You can see Matt Cullen breathing hard, but they iced it, and that line had to stay on the ice. They need a change, all five players.
Jimmy Huard tried to whip it into Rangers ice, and now the Rangers can get a line change.
Yeah, good job by Prouka. He worked to get to the red line to make sure he wouldn't ice it, and then got the puck in deep so they could change.
Up the left wing, penalty coming, and it's going to come against the Rangers, it looks like. Their first of the game.
Looks like this will be a slash on, who's it,
Jason Warren, I believe. He is skating towards the box with 16:52 to go in the second.
The Rangers have done a good job staying out of the box. In fact, they weren't shorthanded at all in the first period. That was the penalty you could see at the far blue line from behind, the slash by Ward, who doesn't like it. But nonetheless, this is a Washington power play that's got some talent. Semin, as we talked about in the first period, he's a forward. He plays the left defense. He's a right-handed shot and can pass, can shoot. And, of course, you've got Ovechkin, who is always dangerous. I don't think he's on the ice right now, though, is he?
Not on the ice
not
right
out
now.
There at this time.
They're 11th in the league away from home, 16th overall. Rangers penalty kill down to 18th overall in the league. Kept in by Lawrence Nicolaud, and the shot from the point just wide. That blast off the stick of Alexander Semin, who you were talking about. Back to the point, it comes again to Nicolaud, and Semin tried to tee it up. Instead passes. Nicolaud fires, and that deflection went over the crossbar. And the scrum continues to the right of Lundqvist, kept in by Semin. Nifty pass by him. Down to Chris Clark. Behind the net, the play. Bouncing around. Shanahan tries to clear, and he does.
Now, Nicolaud, number three, the ex-Ranger, played 9 games for the Rangers back in the 02-03 season, was acquired from Minnesota, and has put up a few points since his recall.
Ovechkin, oh, the perfect setup, and Lundqvist slid across. Might have got a glove on it. Ovechkin moves in again, fires through a screen, didn't get through.
Yeah, that was Pope that blocked it, and I believe it was Pope that helped out on the play just before that, getting over to the other side.
40 seconds left in the man advantage. Ovechkin goes diving to the net. Now Semin with a pass. It bounces over the stick of Dinas Zubras. Ovechkin controls at the left point. Deals it down below the goal line. Has it himself. Tries to feed the slot. Broken up for the moment. Now he gets it back. Ovechkin, top of the faceoff circle, off the skate of Ward. He has it again. Cross-ice pass, big shot, Lundqvist stops it. A huge drive coming from that right point, Brian Pothier.
And the Rangers penalty killers were tired. And this is not only a good save on the shot by Pothier, but Lundqvist holds onto the puck and gets a whistle. Now Pope makes this play here, comes over to help out. Zubras fumbled the puck a little bit, but nonetheless, Pope was in good defensive position and then blocks that shot by Ovechkin as well.
Back to the point, it's won by the Caps. Far side forwards, Kasparaitisen delivers a check. Loose puck taken in a stump move, holding the post and holding on is Lundqvist.
So the penalty is over, Ward comes out of the box, and so both teams back to even strength. Pretty good looking power play by the Washington Capitals. The last chance by Boyd Gordon, tries to make a good move, and there was Lundqvist over there waiting for him. Or Lundqvist, we talked about this last night, where goaltenders so often can help you get out of a slump. And don't blame Lundqvist for his last few games. He's allowed 4 goals now in the last 3 games. And he's just played superb hockey.
Faceoff one back to Roosevelt.
Three. He hasn't allowed one tonight.
No, you're right. Buffalo leading the Thrashers 1-0. They're playing in Buffalo tonight. Briere has 15th of the year. Islanders trailing the Devils on Long Island 1-0. And Toronto has a 1-0 lead on Ottawa. Tampa Bay a 1-0 advantage on Montreal down in Florida. Roosevelt deep in the corner. Caps come up with it, and it's whipped wide on a nifty move there by Boyd Gordon. Bouncing puck kept in at the point, but Roosevelt intercepts. Moves it along the far side boards to center. This is Straka. The Rangers out shooting Washington 16-9 on the game, but 4-0. Haven't had a shot yet in this period. Jágr moving in with speed. Tried to feed Nylander. He gives chase. Back to the point. Shot to Jágr, and he deflected it wide. A nice pass that time by Rakunin. And the puck cleared down the ice. The icing waved off. Kasparaitis gives chase.
Washington has come out in this second period, and their forecheck has been good. Physical. Brashear getting more hits again here to start this period.
Jágr at center. Left point, Cullen. Draws a crowd. Behind the net to Prucha. Prucha trying to feed the slot. Instead leaves for Shanahan, who moves in. Shanahan being covered there by Timo Helbling. A shot deflected off the skate of a defenseman. Another one got in on Kolzik. Had to make a save. And it bounces back to Rangers ice. Tootin gives chase. He touches up for icing. 13:06 left in the second. 2-0 Rangers.
Here's a look at the Cannon goal cam. The Rangers with some offensive zone pressure. Jágr to Nylander. And then the shot, this one is deflected. Beautiful pass, and Jágr just misses on the deflection. Now I mentioned Brashear, that's one hit on Roosevelt. He nailed him down the other corner. And so Brashear has been very active.
Improving digital imaging at work, home, or play Cannon Image Anywhere. 15 years, his fourth team, the free agent Donald Brashear now with the Capitals and still throwing his body around. Face-off one back to the Caps and skating quickly to Rangers ice. Kasparaitis back to pick it up.
Quick change for the Capitals. They want to get Ovechkin on the ice. He's got the puck.
Ovechkin moving in. Tried to tee one up. Broken up by the Rangers, and Cullen has it. That was a nice play by Prucha. Skates into Capital ice, flips it ahead. Taking off his skates, tried to give chase. Digging away, Shanahan cross ice to Cullen. Now Shanahan has it in the near corner. Back behind the net to Prucha. Tried to bank it off his knee to Cullen. The Capitals have it. A 3-on-2 for the moment. Nice check down there. Holding and firing. A shoulder save that time by Lundqvist. As Nicolak got a quick shot on. Here's Hallwig to center. Steaming down the left wing. Little wrist shot stopped by Kolzig. 12 minutes remaining here in the second. Rangers 18-9. The shot's advantage. Ovechkin holds. Tries to feed and batted it right out of the air. Lundqvist had to glove it. That was a baseball-like move by the young Russian.
Yeah, he's an unbelievable athlete, Ovechkin. Yeah, he tried to pass it, bounced up in the air, he knocked it out of midair. He had never played baseball before, and they asked him to go out and throw the first pitch out at one of the Washington games this summer, and everybody was betting that the thing would bounce four times before it got to home plate, threw a strike, went out 4 days later, had never played golf before, went to a charity event where he was on a par three hole. We showed it earlier in the season. Had a hole in one, had never played golf before. And the guy is just, he's something special.
You see, that's a letdown though. Now you don't have that to look forward to. He's got a first hole in one on his first attempt. Puck is loose. And a quick shot taken by Alexander Semin. A penalty is going to be called here on the Rangers. They're second in the period. Caps get the extra man on. And the Rangers trying to break it up but can't do it. Heward shot on a glove save. That was a blast by Heward.
Yeah, Heward
and Lundqvist
really
came up big.
Now, and now Aaron Ward's in the middle of this. Now this has been an intense game. It's been a hard-fought game to this point. And Washington, you knew they wouldn't quit. Ovechkin is out there as well. And these players just don't want to back up both teams. And remember, coming into this game, Washington trailed the Rangers by just a point. Now Pettinger involved with Hall, Ovechkin, Tootin. I mean, this is, you can tell the fans can feel this too. They can feel the intensity. They like what the Rangers are doing.
Hall and Pettinger still jawing away.
You know, they're protecting their goaltender. Aaron Ward was the first one to really react. And now Tootin's heading to the penalty box. And we'll see. Ward is already there. No, Rangers lose two defensemen in this.
Helbling is going in.
Remember, the initial penalty was going to be against the Rangers. So there was a delayed penalty. There's Tuutinen on the slash or hook, whatever they called it. And then Semin ends up with the shot. And eventually everything will end up back at the net. More bumping, more pushing, more shoving. Delayed penalty coming against the Rangers, and Washington just keeps the play going, and eventually they'll get the shot right there. Hewitt's got a terrific shot. And then there goes Ward. Ward wasn't happy. There it is again. Watch Ward. Goes around Ovechkin looking for somebody on the other side. So after all is said and done, the Rangers end up being shorthanded. The original penalty was against Fedor Tuukka. And so the Rangers shorthanded for the second time this period.
So Tuutinen has some company in there with Aaron Ward.
Yeah, two key defensemen in the penalty box.
So the penalties even, two apiece. Both of the Ranger penalties coming here in the second. Rangers had two power plays in the first, one 0-2. And the puck bounces out to center. Michael Rosenthal is on. Jason Ward. Some big hits along the near side boards. Tomas Poeck blasts it down around the boards. Kolzig's got to control it down there.
And by the way, one of the Rangers' top penalty killers, Cullen, went to the Ranger locker room with a skate problem, so he's not available to kill this penalty.
Rangers still playing without Jed Ortmeier. He's headed to Hartford for a few days.
Cullen, by the way, just got back to the Ranger bench. Wasn't much of a problem.
It couldn't have been. That's not even a shoelace problem. A minute five left in the man advantage. Caps trying to just move into the zone, unable to do it. Capitals 16th in the league on the power play, coming in right in the middle of the pack. Play broke under the blue line. Here comes Shanahan skating in. He's taken off his skates, but I think he just lost an edge.
Oh, he was looking for a penalty. The Capitals were in a change.
Ovechkin. Back to the point, it comes to Heward. Cross-ice seven, feeds back to Heward, fires it up, and a shoulder save made by Lundqvist. And out of the zone it comes, 28 seconds left in the man advantage.
Now they have two players back there that can really shoot it, Heward and Semin. And of course there's that Ovechkin kid up front.
The 35-year-old Jamie Heward. Down in the corner he leaves it. Shanahan out at the front trying to kill the penalty. Tomas Poeck tried to poke check it away. The point, Heward. 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left, and Cullen able to clear the zone. Out comes Fedor Tuutinen. And the team's back at even strength. Kolzig had to come out and prevent Jason Ward from having a golden opportunity. Now's Dinas Zubras behind the net. Hallwick doing a nice job of body work there. Puck comes loose and out to Jason Ward, who centers to Betts. So the Caps 0-2 on their power play opportunities, two shots overall.
Good job of penalty killing by the Rangers. And then Kolzig had to be very alert to prevent a breakaway.
Jason Ward turns in the far corner, feeds Rakunic, wrist shot just wide, rebound loose. Kolzig bats it to the corner. 8:40 left in the second, 2-0 Rangers.
Now Rakunic tried to get the shot off quickly, which he did, but he had his head up.
Oh, a centering play there into the slot. Lundqvist holds on. Ben Clymer was moving in. 2-0 Rangers, 8.5 to go in the second.
Look at our Panasonic digital replay. Brendan Shanahan, good call here, Mike. Loses his footing. No contact at all. Tried to get a call. You had the right call. Nice going. Good non-call by the officials. And then Rakunic with this shot. Now he has to shoot it past the players right in front of him and just misses on the short side. Jason Ward on the other side gets a piece of it. And Kolzig was there. And then Hallwig always playing physical. Gets one hit there. Another one here on Gordon. Good solid defensive play by Ryan Hallwig. Leg seems fine.
Yeah, he had that Charlie horse last night, but as he told Al Trawick, it wasn't in his heart. And that's what matters. Here's Straka. Just bounces it out, lofts it out to center where Jágr has it. Three men converge on Jágr. He gives chase. And now in the near side corner, he has possession. Looking to feed Straka. Gets it back. Oh, it's intercepted that time by Sean Morrison. Straka, Jager, and Nylander continue to work, but the puck bounces loose and out of the zone. Puck ricochets to behind the net where Straka gets possession, and now Roosevelt under 8 minutes remaining here in the second. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti, Al Trautwig busily studying the trivia books to find out the answer to our trivia question. Penalty here. Let's see, who's Rangers it going to be
again.
On?
Rangers again, I believe.
And Nylander is really hot.
Now the Rangers didn't take, they were not shorthanded in the first period. And this will be the third time in this period that they'll be shorthanded. Michael Nylander right there. Lifts the stick. You know what? He started going the other way, and it almost looked like the Washington player either put his elbow together against his side to hold the stick and draw, and then go down and draw the penalty.
It looked like it.
The only thing you can do is let go of your stick. And meanwhile, this has been, you know, Brashear has been after Roosevelt the entire game. And why not take him out of the play? Roosevelt, one of their best puck handling and shooting defense. So they've tried to focus on him, or at least Brashear has, and has hit him a good four or five times in this game.
Rangers still playing without Merrick Malik, who's very close. Interception there. Nice play, a takeaway by Betts, and he just chips it behind Kolzig to chew up some time. Nylander in for hooking at 12:23. The Capitals 0-2 on their first two power plays. Bank behind to Ovechkin, back to the point. Now he has it back, and intercepted there by Shanahan. He sends Rakunik in. He's hooked. He shoots. Oh, it hit the post, and it's on the goal line. It nearly went in. And a penalty shot coming for Rakunik.
Now, this all starts in the defensive zone. The Rangers trying to put pressure on Ovechkin when he has the puck. And Rakunik, watch Rakunik go right to him, right here. Forces Ovechkin into a bad pass. Now Shanahan feeds Rakunik, who just continued to go. Ovechkin had to come back on him. And then that puck nearly went in. Look at the pressure, the turnover, the good pass from Shanahan, the breakaway, the hook, the shot, the post, the penalty shot. All in about 10 seconds, Mike.
Excellent, concise description by you, Joe Micheletti. Here it is again.
You know, it was a beautiful play by Rakunik. And that puck, after it hit the post, comes back. Watch it come back. It'll hit Kolzig. And then off the skate, off the post again. And, oh, just inches from going in the net.
And the crowd is on their feet. The Ranger bench really encouraging Rakunik and trying to have a little fun with him, too. His first career penalty shot.
Well, he scored his first career shorthanded goal earlier this year.
And here he comes across the blue line. Kolzig way out. Rakunik shot, stopped by Kolzig.
That would have been a shorthanded goal had he scored. He tried a couple of head deeks, tried to get Kolzig to move, and Kolzig just stayed with him. Watch a little shoulder, a little head deek here, a little bit of this, and then he tries to beat him with the quick shot through the legs. And Kolzig just goes, that was easy. Nothing to it.
Look how far he came out, Kolzig.
Position.
Way out.
Yeah, well, that's what they like to do. They like to come out and then go back with momentum. And Kolzig played it perfectly. Remember that one. I mean, that could have given the Rangers a 3-0 lead. 6:45 to go.
Oh, face-off win by Jason Ward. He got a shot on.
Another good save by Kolzig. 6:45 in the second period.
1 minute remaining. In the penalty to Michael Nylander. Rangers can't capitalize on a penalty shot. Another good shot by Ward, and here come the Caps. Puck bounces out to the right point and off the skate of the Rangers. Jason Ward, he heads to the bench for a line change.
The Rangers desperately need that third goal, and they're getting chances. Kolzig's making saves. They're hitting posts.
Right wing, a setup in the slot for the moment to Nikolat. Behind the net. Now moving along on the near side boards. And bang behind the boards to Chris Beach. Beach tries to feed, and the shot got through. Lundqvist with a kick save. Tough save by Lundqvist. Still in the zone. 10 seconds left in the power play. Back to Nikolat. And blocked by Shanahan. Cleared out of the zone.
What a play. Now that save that Lundqvist made, it looked to me like it deflected off of the body of Brooks Light, number 21. And Lundqvist had to change what he was doing, and what a save he made. And then Brendan Shanahan with the big
hallway ball. Getting decked. An elbow, a left hand from Brashear, two lefts from Brashear. It's all happening in front of the Capitals bench.
Now this has been an active game by Brashear. Very active on the physical side. And that man right there just took a couple of lefts for the team.
We'll be back. 5:21 left in the second. 2-0 Rangers.
Washington with pressure. I thought it went off like the shot, but watch number 23 goes off his skate. That's Rakunic. And Lundqvist had to make a beautiful save. And then Shanahan takes over from there. Pass across. And look at Shanahan. Watch him dive to block this. Beautiful block of the shot, shorthanded by Brendan Shanahan. And then the action down the other end. That's Gordon that gets hit by Hallwig. He sees Brashear coming. Punch, punch, punch. Penalties.
That was a big left overhead.
That's been a fun game.
Overhand by Brashear.
The energy in this game has just been excellent.
Ovechkin in the box along with Brashear. The power play powered by AMD, smarter choice. Double minor on Brashear for roughing.
Two punches, two penalties.
Here's Roosevelt, Straka, now Jágr. Two good left hands. Hallwick got one in two. Puck is loose. Jumped over the stick to Straka. And clearing it out of the zone, Chris Clark.
And again, another opportunity. We talk about opportunities to take control of the game. 2-0 is a good lead. The Rangers are playing well, but it's not a safe lead. 3-0 going into the third. They'd feel much better about that.
We'll never say a safe lead again when we say 3-0 after what happened in Tampa, but it'd be nice. Shot whistled wide.
We're not talking about
that. That's right.
Didn't you hear Perry Pern?
I've got to remember what Perry Pern said. Let's not talk about it. Shanahan moves in, fires wide. He talked about scoring chances with Al Troutwick before. He's had a couple. Now again he sets up. This time feeds down below the goal line. Up the near sideboards. Straka and Nylander play catch. Now Nylander moves back to Marty. Nylander in. Jágr takes a slot and Nylander trying to deflect it, and it's finally broken up by the Caps and sent down to Rangers ice.
Yeah, Rangers, their power play still struggling to get quality shots on goal.
Marty Straka with speed to center, and the pass deflects up into the Rangers bench. Jim Ramsey makes the catch and flips to a fan in the front row down there. Rangers hockey brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver.
You know what? He got the handoff. I think it was Polino that caught it with his left hand and then handed off
right
to Jim Ramsey.
Polino the assist, Ramsey the assist, and the lucky fan the puck. Here's Adam Hall. Lofts it down to the left of Kolzik, bouncing around to the point, kept in for the moment. And on the near side corner, Caps try to move it out of the zone, can't do it. Adam Hall with a nice job of breaking things up. He and Rakunic there, Pruka and Cullen. And it bounces out to center where Fedor Tuukka stands. Ovechkin's back on. Here's Pruka moving in. Tries to reset, and the puck taken away by the Capitals. That play broken up by Cullen, and a penalty coming up.
Too many men against the Rangers. And so they're going to be shorthanded again for the fourth time.
New York Rangers bench minor, too many men.
Yeah, okay. Too many men on the ice. It was the referee that made the call. A lot of times the linesman will see that and make the call, but this time it was the veteran referee, Dan Marowelli. That makes a call. You see all these Rangers jumping over the boards. One, two, three, four. Well, there are too many. We'll believe Dan Marowelli that he made the call. And
referee.
You see Tootin started to go. And stopped and came back on the ice because of a turnover, and that caused a too many men penalty.
Dan Marowelli, Kevin Pollock, the referee, Steve Barton, Greg Dvorsky, the linesman. Tonight at the Garden, we're glad you could join us. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti, and Al Trotwig here on MSG. The Rangers with a 2-0 lead, but the fourth penalty of the period against the Rangers. Colton Orr will serve it, and the puck wrapped around the boards all the way down to Washington ice. Kolzig is there. Chris Beach is on. Too many men penalty coming at 16:56. Final 3 minutes here of the second. In the corner, Chris Clark. Shanahan breaks it up, able to move it to center. And now Alexander Semin has to return. Picked up there on the right wing. Oh, a centering play broken up by Aaron Ward. And a shot kicked out by Lundqvist. Rebound, couldn't be teed up, and out of the zone it comes.
What a shift by Semin. Brendan Shanahan made the defensive play in his own zone, and he tried to go off the boards with it, and it looked like he might have had a breakaway. And Semin, watch Semin, he's a forward. Look at the spinorama. How about one more? And now he keeps going. And watch how he ends up getting the puck. Goes through two men. Shot. Gets the puck again. He'll end up with another shot. Look at this. And Lundqvist had to make the save. That is talent by this young Russian who played a couple years ago, went back, still learning to speak the language, but highly, highly talented.
17 goals, 34 points in 34 games for Alexander Semin, and you can see his great reach and instincts in that last sequence.
Oh, everything. Handling a puck, skating.
Ovechkin. 38 seconds left in the man advantage to Washington. And Marcel also hasn't had much ice time in this game. Broke the play up offside.
You know, I was talking about George McPhee, who's the general manager, and they have the lowest payroll, Washington does, in the National Hockey League. And he said about a month and a half or so ago, he said, you know, if we get the chance, he said, we'll add to our club at the trade deadline if we think we're competitive. And that man right there, as Glenn Hanlon's the head coach, he's done a great job with this team. I mean, they work and compete every game. And he said, when we're in, and George McPhee said, when we're healthy, so I really like what we've got. So they might, you know, they just might add on. They're right in the middle of a playoff race.
Yeah, they're 10th right now. The Rangers 9th by just a point.
When you win a couple of games, you win 2, 3, 4 games, all of a sudden you go from 10th to about 4th or 3rd or 5th or up in that
yeah,
area.
Yeah, we were talking about how streaky this league has been this year. Everyone seems to have gone through, except for Buffalo and Anaheim.
These
kind of long losing streaks.
Yeah. Win 4, lose 5. A lot of teams have gone through that type of thing.
Puck cleared to center. Here's Straka moving in. Goes to his backhand. Still has control. Tries to leave for Jágr. Jágr moving in. Quick shot and a goal! It's Kasperaitis! Jágr set him up! What a play! Kasper! It's 3-0 Rangers!
I'll repeat what we said earlier in the game. This Ranger team is, they're not turning back. Watch how they go forward. They keep going. Straka with the initial move. Now Jágr joins them. And Jágr, there's a delayed penalty against Jágr. He gets hit. Kasperaitis just follows the play up, and what a shot. What a shot by Kasperaitis. Again, the Rangers going north-south, attacking the net, getting the puck to the net, and Kasperaitis just followed it up perfectly, and what a shot. What a huge goal for the Rangers with under a minute to go in the second period. Jágr with a big play. Straka with a big play. And now Orr and Brashear with big haymakers.
They're tugging, they're pulling. Brashear going for the shirt. He's got that big left. And now Colton Orr answers with a couple of rights. And Orr working from close in. And Brashear unloading with left hands. They both go down, and that's the end of it. 46 seconds left in the period, and the Rangers all standing on their bench. Brashear glaring over there.
Yeah, but you know what? That's a good response by Orr. Brashear's got in a lot of hits on the Ranger players in this game, a lot of their key players. And Orr was looking for something with Brashear in the first period. And I'm not sure Brashear wanted to get involved at that time. But right here, off, you know, we saw this early in the game, and they, for some reason, decided not to get involved. But there was no question about this one. And Orr looked to be the aggressor. But Brashear's a tough guy. He is a tough guy. He's got a tremendous left hand. He's big and strong. And so is Orr, who can take a punch and then got a few in himself.
Meanwhile, Kasparaitis is red hot, Joe. 2 goals in 7 games. 27 in his career now.
They got to feed him more.
Get him the puck.
Why Tom Rennie's not using him on the power play?
I don't understand. We'll have to talk to the coach before the next game. Shot bouncing around to the left of Lundqvist here. Final 30 seconds of the period. There's a glove on the ice. Back to the point it comes.
Rakunics.
And that shot deflected wide of Lundqvist. Straka's there to pick it up. But now in the slot, a shot and a shoulder save by Lundqvist prevented the goal.
That almost looked like it caught the post as well.
Final seconds of the period, and the Rangers will go to the dressing room with a 3-0 lead, thanks to Darius Kasparaitis. And that has the crowd on their feet.
Well, such an important goal, because the Rangers, who were not shorthanded in the first period, were shorthanded 4 times in the second period. And it's been a while. Tampa Bay, right? 3-0.
We were there. The Rangers holding a 3-0 advantage, ready to pocket 2 points, and it didn't happen.
You know, it looks like a different Ranger team in this game, though. Playing with a lot of heart and energy, and there's the third goal, that one by Darius Kasparaitis, and he should be smiling. And his teammates happy for him. He played a hard, tough game last night against Ottawa physically. And nice to see him get that goal.
Now we join Al Trumwick downstairs with Lawrence Nicolet.
All right, Mike, he's just getting his gear taken care of. And Lawrence, of course, a former member of the Rangers organization, signed as a free agent by Washington, called up from Hershey. You're the captain of that team, and you scored a goal, your first NHL goal, and got your first assist last night. Was that a big deal for you?
Yeah, it was definitely an exciting thing for myself. It's one of those things you think about growing up, and happily I was able to get one, and I was pretty happy.
You get a lot of ice time in a game like this, and you haven't been able to put one past the Rangers' defense here in this game. Is your team frustrated at this point?
Yeah, I think that they're doing a really good job of clearing out rebounds. We're not getting a lot of second, third chances. So the only thing we can do is start throwing more pucks towards the net and crashing, and hopefully we're going to start getting second and third chances.
But your story is an interesting one, because the team's trying to win and start something and end the losing, and yet you're trying to make an impression and stay with this team, and you're getting your sort of good news story taken care of, aren't you?
Yeah, well, I mean, anytime anyone gets called up, you want to do well, you want to prove yourself and show that you can compete at this level, but at the same time, you want to help the team win. I know that no one's 100% happy with just developing people. I know people want to win, and so that's the main thing for all us guys from Hershey that are here right now. We want to help the team win.
Thanks, Lawrence. And Mike, in Hershey, he's the captain, and that tells you a little bit about him.
Thanks very much.
All right, thanks so much, Al. Lawrence Nicolet, interesting story. Up from Hershey to play for the Caps tonight. Rangers leading 3-0, our second intermission coming up. New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by Canon, improving digital imaging at work, home, or play. Canon Image Anywhere. By Cablevision, for the best products and the best value for your home or business, it's optimum or it's not. By Ford, check out the best-selling Ford Explorer at a price that's even better, only your tri-state Ford dealer. And by Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest. Mike Crispino, Joe Micheletti, Al Trautwick, a look at the GW Bridge. And we're back inside the Garden, the world's most famous arena. Time for a trivia, the quiz earlier. The question this: Adam Graves leading the Rangers with 23 goals against the Capitals. Which Capitals player has the most goals against the Rangers? Now, I want to apologize here to the fans of the Rangers. I've been handing my points to Sam Rosen all along. I've known Sam
points?
15 years when I do get one right, not all that often. But I've got to go with the Ranger fans on this one. I'm not going to say it's Peter Bondra. I'm going with Mike Gartner.
All right. I am, by the way, next time, just read War and Peace as you explain where your points are going, okay?
Okay.
I'm going A, Peter Bondra.
They're just going along with the majority, right, Al?
I am too.
I'm not. I actually picked Bondra because he's the only one who was never on the Rangers.
Oh,
all right. Well, that's
I'm gonna go with
some logic.
I'll go
to
with
that.
Bondra also.
Oh, you always say what Al says.
Good choice, Joe.
It's always what Al says.
I go with Mr. Google.
Yeah, baby.
Oh,
yeah, baby.
My guy. He's my guy.
Mr. Google gets it right for
it
a change.
Fans are gonna be happy with you, Mike.
No, they're not.
Should have given those points to Sam.
I thought I said Bondra, didn't I?
Uh-oh.
Oh, man.
Here we go. Oh, man. Sam now.
Sam is in third place, Joe.
Fans
he is not going to be happy in New Jersey.
I'll be right back. I'm going to make a little phone call here.
Oh, he's calling him right now, Al.
I love it.
There's a hockey game going on. You can't make a call to Sam.
I got to give Sam a little call.
Joe's still leading by a mere point. Al Trotwick coming
Sam
up big.
A little call here. Just
and a disappointing performance by yours truly. Well, this third period about to begin. The Rangers with a 3-0 lead. Tonight, the big four of the Rangers have been on. Jágr with the assist on the last goal by Cass Brightus. Shanahan talked about those scoring chances with Al at the top of the show. Four good shots tonight. Nylander a goal and an assist. Marty Straka, two assists. The Rangers leading 3-0, headed to the third. The Rangers with the lead after two are 12-2-2 this season. Two of those losses coming in this seven-game stretch of losses for the Rangers, in which they have not gotten a point in 16 games. Ryan Hallwig and company, I'm sure, were talking about that prior to this one. Stay tuned after the game for the latest edition of the 50 Greatest Moments in Madison Square Garden, hosted by Matthew Modine. Don't miss a moment as we count down to number one following the Rangers here on MSG, presented by Saab and Budweiser. Plus, the 50 Greatest Moments is available now on demand for IO customers on Channel 604. Great series of pieces from the world's most famous arena. Blair Betts and the Rangers. Third period set to begin. Brashear still in the box. And Colton Orr as well. They've been banging bodies. So
all right,
Michael Nylander said.
We left the message. Sam got the message.
So Joe Micheletti trying to get me in hot water with Sam Rosen and effective again.
He wanted to know.
He wanted to know.
He's in New Orleans. He was anxious.
He was anxiously awaiting. He doesn't want to know.
He wanted to know. And I also informed him that, of course, you decided not to give your point. Had you won, you decided not to give your points to him. Well, right off the bat, is this a penalty? Off the glass.
And Nylander pointed up there, but they didn't call it. So we're still 5-on-5. Washington this year, 5-on-5. 67 goals for, 83 against. Puck set to center. Backed out of the boards, out of the Ranger ice by Tomas Poeg, who has it behind the goal.
Mike, Rangers just need a good start. You know, they've played hard in this game. They've done a lot of the right things by keeping the puck going forward. That's what they need to continue to do. Get the puck in, no turnovers, and keep the pressure on in Washington's end.
Polk banging bodies that time. Down below the goal line with Matt Pettinger. And Straka lifts it over to Tomas Poeg, and here comes Rosenthal. Marty Straka to center. Whips
it
around
again.
The boards.
You know what? How many times have you seen the Rangers, that line in particular, when they get to the blue line and no play, dump it in? Hasn't happened.
Loose puck and the play broken up by Tootin.
You know, it's a big change for that line. I mean, they're used to handling the puck and making plays. Now they're keeping their team out of trouble by just making the safe play and getting it in.
And then going after it, trying to retrieve it. Here's Shanahan. With speed down the right wing. Feeds to Cullen. Backhand shot. Kicked aside by Kolzig. The Rangers 23 shots on goal. Washington 14. Peter Pruka had the first goal of the game just 2 minutes in. And Shanahan pumps it ahead. Heads to the bench.
Yeah, there it is. It's a simple little play. Little dump in. Allows the line to change. forces Washington to go back and get it in their own zone and go 200 feet to try to make a play.
Well, remember, as Ovechkin has possession, this is a bit of a tired Washington team. Four games in five nights.
Sure is. And that is unusual.
Yeah, they've lost five of six, three in a row.
Mike, I can't remember the last time a National Hockey League team had to play four games in five nights.
Yeah, that's something you hear in the NBA, like the Knicks might do.
Years ago they used to, but not in recent memory.
Holwick rips one. Kolzik had to make a stop. Now skating with speed to center, Steve Eminger. And Holwick fanned on a pass for the moment. Roosevelt lifts it to center, the bouncing puck in, and icing waved off as Brian Pothier gives chase. Centering play, in on the wing. Kasparaitis blocked the shot of Chris Beach.
By the way, Aaron Ward is without a skate. They're doing some fixing in the room.
Rangers, who've been without Merrick Malik the past several games, may get him back as early as next week against New Jersey.
He had a good skate this morning with Perry Pern. Simulated 20 shifts is what they went through this morning at the practice facility, and he felt a little soreness in there but was able to go through that without too much trouble. So there's a good chance he could play next game.
Yeah, he's had a little trouble pushing off, making quick starts with that groin, and has stayed out of the lineup. Roosevelt rips through a screen wide. Back to center, where Tootin stops the rush as he bang bodies there with David Steckel. This is Jason Ward, wraps it around the boards, heads to the bench for a line change. Shanahan on with Peter Prucha. As the Rangers have played a good positional game tonight. Big hit on Tootin, it's going to be icing.
You know, Mike, it's been a very methodical first 4 minutes for the Rangers here in the third period. Now this was close enough. Bettinger made a good effort. And it wasn't a cheap shot on two. And Ward earlier with the pass up to Shanahan. Shanahan to Cullen. Cullen with the shot. But we played 4 minutes and the Rangers have done this type of thing. Up the ice, when the play is there, make it. When it's not, the Rangers have dumped it in back behind the net. Ovechkin noticeable every time he's on the ice.
He's a big time player. He attracts contact and he gives it too.
He loves the game. He loves playing, and he'll play in every aspect of it.
Slap shot taken from the point by Polk, but it's locked down by the defense. Lifted into the Rangers end of the ice. Lacuna gives chase with Matt Pettinger, and the Rangers have it. Well, you recall, Joe, when we were in Tampa Bay, those opening 6 minutes with the Lightning erased that three-goal lead in the offside there. The Rangers were not playing this kind of hockey in the opening minutes of the third. Well, the Rangers Road Tour, presented by Snapple Iced Tea, is up to hitting the road again. With its interactive games and activities and knowledgeable hockey staff, the Road Tour is perfect for any sized event 365 days a year. For more information, visit NewYorkRangers.com. Aaron Ward back on the bench, had the skate repaired.
Yeah, still adjusting it. Sometimes when you put it on in a hurry to get back out there, you don't tighten it exactly the way you need to or to your comfort level. So Aaron Ward is doing a little adjusting as he keeps an eye on loose pucks.
In his 12th season, Aaron Ward, first with the Rangers. Number one on the team in block shots so far. Penalty here. It's going to be on, let's see, I think it's going to be on Yager.
Brashear drew the penalty. He went right to Yager, to Jaromír Jágr, and hit him. And Jágr kind of got his stick up, and Brashear went down. Jágr didn't have the puck. Let's see what happens. Oh, Brashear first off the faceoff, gets his left elbow up. Nothing was called there. And then now watch him go right to Jágr right there. And he makes contact, but Jágr got the stick up and then threw him down, so that's the penalty. Jágr was a little incensed, I think, right off the start because Brashear gave him the elbow. Oh, and then he went there, and Brendan Shanahan having a few words with Brashear.
So the Rangers will have to kill a penalty here in the opening 5 minutes of the third. Bouncing puck. chipped out of the zone. Interference, Jaromir Jagr at 424 of the third. Dinas Zubris angles it across ice. Kept in by Alexander Semin. Zubris fires. Lundqvist held his ground and made the stop.
Yeah, Tom Rennie, I had a conversation with him this morning. We were talking about last night and a lot of the things that were going on and what was going on lately. Here's the last shot again. Pettinger in front, but Lundqvist just gobbles it up. And Shanahan saying a few things to Brashear, but he talked about Shanahan and his leadership ability and how he keeps players calm. And we heard, you know, we heard Ryan Hallwig tell Al Troutwig before the game that it was, you know, Brendan Shanahan got up before the game and just said, hey, listen, what's in the past is in the past. Let's move forward. Let's keep playing. You know, he's done a little bit of everything for this team.
Well, a shot ripped off the glass behind Lundqvist. Well, that's the problem with a losing streak. If you reflect it all on what's been happening, you get in a kind of a negative mindset, but the Rangers have overcome that tonight. They lead 3-0, just 5 minutes into the third. Steaming in the left wing, Ovechkin backhand! Lundqvist made a save, a penalty coming.
Boy, Lundqvist is hurt.
And Lundqvist is down, and he is rolling around.
Oh boy, that, you know, Ovechkin had a tremendous amount of speed going the other way, and when he got taken down, it looked like he went in skates first. And Jim Ramsey is out there trying to talk to Lundqvist.
Ovechkin right came leg. Off that left wing with a lot of speed.
Yeah. Ovechkin, when he got that speed and he knew he had a step, and he just lowered his shoulder and then was tripped on the play and then was out of control. So he had all that speed going right towards Lundqvist, and he got tripped down, and I think both players went in. There's Semin, and then there he goes, and he knows he's got, look at the speed. And down he goes.
Oh, it was the skate of the Ranger. Well, the defenseman, I think, Tootin up in the face. I don't know.
Tootin was there trying to cut him off. There's the trip. And let's watch a skate.
Yeah, there's
oh,
the
boy.
Skate right
skate
in the face
high.
Below the mask, perhaps.
Down he goes. The collision with Tootin. The skate comes up and catches Lundqvist in the mask. But I don't think that was it. I think it was the leg that bothered him on the collision. The mask saved him.
Yeah, Vetchkin ran into him.
The mask saved him because the skate blade, watch the skate blade come up and catch him in the face. That mask saved him right there. Nothing happened to the head. It was more the leg because of the collision.
Right, yeah, that kind of hyperextended his leg a little bit.
That's a tremendous collision. And what happened was his right leg was kind of braced against the post, so there wasn't a lot of give right away.
So it's 5-on-3 for a minute 12 here. The Rangers with a 3-0 advantage. And the faceoff, Blair Betts can't win it, but the Rangers have possession and Roosevelt clears. Roosevelt poke Blair Betts on for the Rangers. And Roosevelt makes a nice play at the blue line.
Yeah, the Rangers got to have to bail out their players that took the penalties. The last one was inadvertent, but Jagr took a bad one to start all this.
Ovechkin deals to the top of the faceoff circle. Now Holes doesn't shoot. Here's a shot wide from Dinas Zubris. Karam's back out to the far side boards. Ovechkin standing right in front of the goal, doesn't shoot it. Zubris does. Lundqvist save. Bouncing puck loose. And behind the net now. Polk digging. Betts there. It's under Polk. And he's hanging on. He refuses to give it up. Roosevelt has it. Can't clear it out. Ovechkin back at the point. 10 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Clark got decked in front of the net by Polk. Zubris. Now holds, looks down low, poked away from him. Jagr's back in it. It's 5-on-4 now. And Jagr can't clear it out, and eventually it is. Jagr with it to Betts. Now Ovechkin. And he can't keep it in. Betts fires off the boards. Still loose at center. 25 seconds left in the man advantage.
That could have been too many men on the ice for Washington. That's what the crowd is yelling about.
Ovechkin set up. Big blast over the crossbar. 15 seconds left. And a wrister. Lundqvist saves. Rebound. Kicked wide. And play stopped. Yeah. 9 seconds left in the power play.
The whistle blew because the referee thought it was frozen. Throughout this 5-on-3. Now, this is just a wrist shot, and the Rangers will give them that any time. And they thought the whistle blew when Beach took the shot because they thought that Lundqvist had it. Now, you see, Lundqvist seems to be okay after injuring the leg on the collision. But you know something throughout that? It was over a minute of the 5-on-3. Ovechkin, no shots.
Minute 12 through a screen, a drive wide. Behind the net, that's Kasparaitis. Now we're 5-on-5 again. Rangers killing off a 5-on-3, then a 5-on-4. Pope checked away, Rakunic up the board, Shanahan and out of the zone. 12 and a half to go, and the Rangers 3-0.
Huge penalty kill.
Bouncing puck, and the Caps are offside. Back to the Garden, a 3-0 Ranger lead.
Here's our Panasonic digital replay. There's Alexander Ovechkin. He's got the puck, he passes it. Now watch, he never gets it back. This was a long 5-on-3 for Washington. The good news for the Rangers is that Ovechkin never shot the puck. They didn't get it back to him. They had other players taking the shot instead of looking to get back to him. He's got 25 goals this year, which is tied for the league lead, and they never got him the puck for the shot. And this is during the TV timeout. Lundqvist is saying,
"I didn't
mean
right.
to. I didn't mean to. I mean, you did it okay. Good try. Here we got another fight.
And now Shanahan
Brashear.
Shanahan Brashear right in the center of the Garden. Brashear's got that left hand. Shanahan lining him up. Throws a couple lefts. Shanahan grapples. He's had it with Brashear tonight. So Shanahan taking him on, the crowd on their feet.
I tell you what, this guy is a first ballot Hall of Famer.
Couple left hands.
He does everything. He stands up for his teammates. I mean, you wonder why New York fans are in love with him. I mean, this is the way he's been through his career.
An uppercut from Shanahan and a left hand. Brashear trying to pull the jersey of an up hand. An uppercut by Shanahan and down he goes. And this Garden crowd on their feet.
Look at this. People are on their feet.
18,200 strong. And another battle. Shanahan took a right hand shot at Ward.
That was Brashear. That sucker punch.
Brashear with a cheap shot.
That was a sucker punch.
And Ward is hurting.
That was a sucker punch.
Aaron Ward. Wow.
Well, Brashear was running around hitting every Ranger he could tonight. And Shanahan had some words with him earlier. And I'll tell you what.
And
Brendan Shanahan is something. And then Aaron Ward said something to him, and it was a sucker punch by Brashear, which will be reviewed by the league, believe me. You know, just earlier, Shanahan said something. You know why? Because he was sticking up for Jágr because Brashear elbowed him, and he backs up his words. I mean, he doesn't talk and then go the other way. I mean, he never has. And he's going against one of the toughest guys in the league for a long, long time.
And Brashear missed with that right hand to start it, then Shanahan got inside with a couple uppercuts.
When you talk about leadership, I mean, leadership in a lot of different ways.
And now a couple of right hands in the face of Aaron Ward.
You see Brashear.
A sucker punch.
Brashear was trying to. He got him with a right in the jaw.
I don't know if Ward said something to him or not, but
I mean, this
Brashear just unloaded.
No, this has got to be. Well, Ward is going to the penalty box. Maybe for unsportsmanlike conduct, for maybe skating up to Brashear and saying something. But Brashear gets, right now anyway, I think he gets an extra 5 minutes for hitting Ward. Ward's probably going to get unsportsmanlike conduct for going in and saying something to him.
Looks that way.
And Brashear is getting 5 minutes. So Brashear and Shanahan's fight will offset each other, probably. The additional is the couple of punches that he threw at Ward, Aaron Ward, and then Ward, I believe, gets an unsportsmanlike. But this is what Shanahan would incense Shanahan, that Brashear went after Yager. And then Yager ends up taking the penalty because he was frustrated and kind of went back at Brashear. So Brashear drew the penalty. But when he went back to the bench is when Shanahan was talking to him as he was going back to the bench and yelling at him. And the next time they get on the ice, you know, Brendan Shanahan, he'll square off with anybody. I mean, he's just, you know, he's
Shanahan
just,
standing up.
He's one of those special players.
Yeah, standing up for Yager, obviously.
He stands up for everybody.
Had a few words for Brashear, and I thought that might come to a head, and it did.
You know, if you were to ask the question, you know, who's the one player that game in and game out all year has stood up when they needed somebody to stand up, scored goals, killed penalties, blocked shots in this game, and you wonder why the people in New York are in love with the guy.
38 you know? Years old, nearly 20 years in the league. Here it is.
Yeah, and he just says, fine. You know, that's, you know, this is one of the reasons why he's got so much respect around
Shanahan
the league.
Shanahan had maybe a little boxing background because he moved over.
Listen, he's a tough guy.
He moved over to avoid that left hand, defend himself.
Brendan Shanahan's a tough guy, and he's always played that way. I mean, you talk about a complete hockey player. Oh, man, he ranks right up and near the top of all time as far as complete players.
4-on-4 for a minute 45. Nylander stick handles. Yager behind Kolzig. Still hanging on. Backhands it to Nylander behind the net. So Shanahan right in the heart of Madison Square Garden, squaring off with bad boy Brashear. Let's send it down to Al Trotwig.
Mike, I don't know anything more than this, but when Donald Brashear came off the ice, he asked one of the first people that he saw that he needed a doctor. I'll see if I can find more.
All right. Well, Brashear took a couple of uppercuts from Shanahan. We'll see what happened there. Here are the Caps 4-on-4. Centering play broken up there by Jason Ward. And the shot blocked down by Tomas Polk. Under a minute left in the 4-on-4. Here's Ovechkin open. Backhand. Lundqvist stymies him. What a play by Henrik Lundqvist.
Ovechkin steals the puck. The Rangers haven't turned it over much. They lose it there, and here comes Ovechkin. Backhand. Save. Tries to get his own rebound. We haven't seen the Rangers make many poor decisions in this game. That was a poor decision going back towards the net in your own end with the puck.
Well, the fans chanting Henrik Lundqvist's name. We haven't heard a lot of that this season, but they're into it here tonight.
Yeah, he seems fine after that scare. Looked like a bad leg on the collision a little earlier in this period. The leg looks fine, and he's made some good saves.
Hossa leaves. Kunik tried to center in the slot to Betts, broken up. Back to the point, kept in by Hossa. 19 saves so far for Henrik Lundqvist. Hossa tying up two of the Caps and took it away again as Straka's there. Finally, Jamie Heward has it. Tomas Polk having a tough time here. Nifty move and a shot. Wow, what a play by Alexander Semin. He's had quite a night.
He made three or four shifty moves. I mean, he went left, right, left, right. And then the shot. We talked about Semin's talent, and you'll see it again here. Spinorama. Now watch him. Back, left, right, shot. That's some kind of talent. There it is again. I mean, look at just dancing on his skates, just dancing. And then the quickness and the great hands with the quickness, the ability to get the shot off that quickly.
Boy, he has been impressive. Midway in the third, the Rangers leading 3-0. Now a 3-minute penalty. Their power play ineffective so far tonight. Behind the net, Nylander back to the point, rolls the ball. Now Straka on the far side.
back to the point. Roosevelt rips. Save Kolzik. Big rebound. Cleared aside. Jágr picks it up. Back to the point. Tomas Poeg keeps it in. Wraps it around the boards to Nylander. Now Jágr. Roosevelt at the point. And Poeg toward the net. Kolzik had to kick it aside. Here's Straka. He's had a good night tonight. Roosevelt down deep to Nylander. Nylander turns, fires just wide of Kolzik. Now back to the point, kept in by Roosevelt. Wrapped around the boards. Jágr stops it there, moves in. Nifty stick work, save Kolzik, and it's cleared out.
A good strong move by Jágr. By the way, Brashear needed a doctor because he cut his right hand. Is cut, so that's why he needs a doctor to look at that.
Well, he's thrown a bunch of punches in this one. Colton Orr, and now with Shanahan. Pruka skating quickly. Sends it to the corner, but wrapped around the boards. Kept in by Cullen. Now back to the point where Fedor Tuten has wrists it in on Kolzik. Cullen tried to deflect it in. And Ovechkin now skating with speed up the left side. Couple of moves and a shot. Stick saved by Lundqvist. Boy, Ovechkin can unload from any angle.
Yeah, Fedor Tuten played him pretty well.
Now Cullen, a nifty move by Cullen. Shot in the glove, save by Kolzig as Adam Hall got a good shot in on him.
Now Cullen with one hand on the stick makes a nifty little move, but can't regain control of the puck. But Adam Hall, who follows it up, gets it on the forehand. And Adam Hall dying for a goal as well. And this is a good, strong move by Jágr earlier. And Kolzig, who is 6'4", is there to cover up.
Under 8.5 minutes remaining in the hockey game. The Rangers still with a minute left in the man advantage. They've had 3 minutes of it, 2 minutes of it up to now. Trying to connect on their power play. Now Rakunic. The offensive zone. Cullen fires. Kolzig finally controls the rebound. Holds on with 44 seconds left in the man advantage.
Rangers 28 shots on goal now to 20 for Washington. And the Rangers have done a much better job of keeping that puck in play going forward through the neutral zone. The last shot, rising shot by Cullen. Kolzig off the shoulder and then controls.
Olaf Kolzig, 36 years old, born in South Africa. 18th year in the league, 33 career shutouts.
And played for Germany in the Olympics as his German citizenship.
Exactly. 7th on the active wins list for goalkeepers. Here's Nylander with a shot over the crossbar.
You know, Mike, the goaltender can't wear the C for the captaincy, but everyone will tell you that Kolzig is the leader of this team.
Jágr fires. Kolzig holds on.
No, he's their emotional leader. What he says and does, everyone else follows. He's a terrific individual and a real competitor. And you know, he had a chance last year to get traded at the deadline. His contract was up, and he said, I want to stay in Washington. And that man right there, Glenn Hanlon, the head coach, has really helped provide a type of atmosphere, a winning atmosphere. And Kolzig wants to stay here and follow it through.
Shot stopped by Kolzik. Rebound bounced out to Aaron Ward. Doesn't shoot it. Set up in the slot. Bets just wide. Hallwig digging. Power play over for the Rangers. Here's Adam Hall. Hallwig on the far side boards. Back to the point. Fedor Tuten trying to wrist it through. Knocked down by the defense. That's Ovechkin playing some defense. Or rather, Steckel there. And Aaron Ward has it behind Lundqvist. Under 7 minutes remaining in regulation, and the Rangers leading 3-0.
That was Semin with a big hit on Ryan Hallwig. Now Hallwig goes after Zubras with a hit. Zubras responds with a left, and they...
And no. Colton Orr trying to go after one of the Caps.
Now Colton Orr, I think, must have jumped in afterwards.
We'll be back. The Rangers leading 3-0 in the third.
3-0, but they keep working. This is Alexander Semin with the big hit on Hallwig. Pavlovich says, wait a second, now I got to hit somebody. Who can I find? Oh, all right, here's Zubras. I'll go after him, and Zubras with the bear hug. Colt Knorr happens to come on the ice at the time, and he got involved and ended up taking a penalty. There was, oh, that was Orr the slash, Nicolet, and so that's what they call it. So Orr ends up in the penalty box, Rangers shorthanded. By the way, when Brendan Shanahan came out of the penalty box, there you see what he's done. They gave him a standing ovation, and they started cheering in unison. Shanny. I mean, this, they love him, don't they?
Well, we've heard that about Shanahan now and Henrik Lundqvist tonight, so the Rangers trying to snap this seven-game losing streak. 6:20 away from doing it. Shot blasted wide. Zubras across the goal crease to Ovechkin. Now Nicolat back to Ovechkin into the slot. Zubras deflected it wide. Kasparaitis there. Rakunic wraps it around the boards and out. Caps are 0-6 on the power play. They've had 8 shots on it. And they have another minute 20 left. Puck is lifted into Rangers ice where Tootin is there. Blasted around the boards but not out. Ovechkin kept it in along the near side half boards. Now Zubras. Back to the point where Huard stands. Left point, back to Huard. Now Zubras, Aaron Ward out, the shot wide. It's actually pad save up onto the screen by Lundqvist.
Yeah, it might have been deflected just in front of him as well. I thought it was deflected by a Washington player. Now during the break, I talked about Shanahan coming out of the penalty box and getting the standing ovation. And Tom Rennie comes over to him and said, please don't fight anymore. I don't want you to get hurt your hands. Please.
If you're going to drop the gloves, try it against somebody else.
Yeah. Do it with your kids. At home, those little three-year-olds.
But by the way, thanks for doing it. Tom Rennie has, been struggling to get this Rangers team back on the winning track here over the last couple weeks. And right now they lead 3-0 with 5:20 remaining.
The thing about Tom Rennie, he doesn't panic. I said this morning, he says, I'm getting this team ready to win this game like I did last game, to win that game, and he doesn't panic. You want to win, absolutely.
Yeah, the team reflects that as well. A lot of solid veterans, and when you're in this kind of a rut, you need that kind of leadership. Marty Straka talking to Al Trotwick before the game, I thought was pretty cool for a guy sitting in the middle of a seven-game losing streak.
Yeah, they feel the pressure. I mean, those top players know that they have to score, that's where the Rangers get their offense from, and when they don't, they feel the pressure.
Lundqvist hangs onto it there and leaves it for Roosevelt. Roosevelt lifts it to center, and that's going to be an icing call, unless Colt Knorr gets there first, and he doesn't. 4:32 left in regulation, 3-0 Rangers. Tom Rennie's team came into this game ninth in the East. Unable to get a point in their last 7 games over 16 days. He's remained cool and kept his poise. And tonight the Rangers rewarding him with an effort. They lead 3-0, 4:32 to go.
There's a lot more fire in that exterior than you see from the exterior.
I think he took it out on me a little, Joe, outside the dressing room. Gave me a bump. I thought he was trying to check me. The coach getting fired up for it. A lot of people try to do that. It seems to work. And out to center. Well, Zubras might have run into his own man there. Wait a minute. Colt Knorr going after.
Yeah, that was Orr.
One of the Caps.
He went after Zubras because of that other incident. And this is getting ugly. Sean Morrison then went after Colt Knorr. Morrison just back in the lineup. He had lost a lot of weight because he had mononucleosis. So he just got back in the lineup yesterday, and now the officials are trying to keep this thing under control.
Still 4 minutes and 20 seconds left. And Ranger fans, the most noise we've heard really all season long in the building.
Colt Knorr will get thrown out. What he did to Zubras was a little behind the play. I didn't see exactly what it did, but I can only surmise that it had something to do with the previous play we saw earlier. Oh, let's see. Oh, that was...
Johnson
Oh, that was,
as Ovechkin that got rocked.
Okay, this was Ovechkin. Oh, Ovechkin that got hit by Orr. Okay, Zubrus was the other player that got hit. And this was Ovechkin. That was Zubrus. And then Ovechkin, well, that, you know what? It's a cheap shot
that
by
is.
Orr. You know, he wasn't looking. Now Ovechkin's had a lot of shots, but that's Orr gets the stick up and the elbows up. And gives Ovechkin is okay.
Boy, might have shook some teeth loose though.
Yeah.
That stick came up high.
You know, he gave it. It was a cheap shot because he was looking the other way and didn't have the puck. But the Rangers, you just have this feeling the Rangers are tired of getting hit and tired of what's been going on, and they're willing to pay whatever price they got to pay, and they'll pay a price for some of these things that are happening late.
Well, it was time they responded,
as will Brashear,
right?
For doing what he did, and so it's their teams are taking turns going at one another.
Well, it was time the Rangers did respond. They have been getting pushed around a little bit of late during this losing streak. Game misconduct for Colton Orr. Yeah, he might have a loose tooth or two on the bottom row there. It's called a charge and then 5 minutes for fighting.
Yeah, he gets two for charging Ovechkin. And Sean Morrison gets two for instigating in a 5 minute major.
All of it happening at 15:40 of the third.
Let's see, it looks like it's all evening up.
It's been that long, Joe, since we've seen that many fights in a hockey game.
Hey, listen, it's a frustrated group. You know, it's a frustrated group when you're around them on a day-by-day basis. They're frustrated. People saying they're not, you know, they're not tough enough, they're not sticking up for each other enough, they're not doing this, not doing that, not doing, you know, that's what happens when you don't win.
Well, the Rangers,
I mean, you're under that microscope of criticism.
Yeah, taking out their frustration a little on the Capitals. It's been a tough two weeks.
And now the Capitals are getting a penalty. This is going to be, Dan Marinelli had enough. And so Marinelli gives a two minute minor for, I believe, unsportsmanlike conduct. And so the Rangers will end up with a power play. And now Glenn Hanlon can't figure it out, so he wants to take a timeout. And what happened was Dan Marinelli had enough. Somebody kept yapping at him. And so he said, that's it. Enough. He just had it. So the officials are trying to make sure this thing doesn't get out of control.
Well, it's been a rough and tumble Saturday night affair here at the Garden. Morrison gone to 2 minutes for instigating, then the fighting misconduct. Tonight at 10:30, catch MSGNY presented by ChevyOffers.com. Highlights reaction from this game. Al Trouble will be on end. He saw a lot of what happened tonight as the Rangers 4 minutes and 20 seconds away from snapping this seven-game losing streak.
Alexander Semin, I don't think it was him that... I don't know what he said. He doesn't speak very good English. He might have said something, and it might have been interpreted a little differently from the referee, or correctly.
See, one of the advantages of not speaking that much English, you can say what you want. Yeah, sometimes the referee doesn't know exactly what you just said.
So we thought.
maybe Dan Marinelli had some kind of an interpreter give him a little bit of a interpretation of what
there are certain words that are universal.
Yes, there are. Here's Jágr. Rangers have not scored on the power play tonight. Yarmer moves in to the face-off, top of the face-off circle. Nylander moves in, banks it back to him. Looking for somebody in the slot. Fired a shot high over the crossbar. And out of the zone it comes. Semin gets the unsportsmanlike conduct. 15-40. Rangers 0-5 on a power play for their last 42. They have had 14 shots on goal. Cross-eye Shanahan banks off the boards to Jágr. Nice pass, Rakunic. Shanahan lines it up, fires. Kolzik stops it. It's loose. And now Kolzik throws a punch.
Kolzik got bumped into. He had the puck. And was it Nylander that was there? I was thinking it was Nylander on the shot. But the question was, did Nylander get bumped first before he hit Kolzik? Shanahan took the shot. And I think the I think the contact was Nylander and Kolzig, and then Kolzig showed his frustration with a punch with the glove. Shanahan, here's the shot.
Oh, his elbow happened, or something.
Well, Nylander got pushed from behind, and his elbow, his left elbow in the face mask. Here it is again. Watch the push right there. And that's where the contact was made, and then Kolzig is just frustrated as well.
It was Timo Helbling who pushed Nylander right into Kolzig.
Yeah, see, there it is, and you see the contact, the left elbow.
He threw a haymaker.
Yeah, did he ever.
So the whistle stopped the play, though, before the puck came loose. So no goal. Rangers still with 35 seconds left in the man advantage. Pruka moving in. Feeds. There's Matt Cullen. Cullen back to the point where Tootin is. Tootin cross ice for Kunik. Cross ice pass. In for a backhand. Rebound, score! Peter Pruka. He's got two. And it's 4-0 Rangers. Pruka, the cap killer. He's got two off the rebound.
Well, the shot from the point, get it through. One chance by Hall, he can't score. And Peter Pruka just follows up the play, and maybe this will get him going. Hall has struggled to score goals and missed a golden opportunity there. But Peter Pruka, look at the stick on the ice and the quick release. And he got all of that one to make it 4-0, and the Rangers have played a heck of a game.
Now moving it on Lundqvist. Oh, and a goal. The shutout averted with 2:29 remaining. And the answer from Ben Clymer. And Lundqvist's shutout bid is ended.
And the fans are starting to get on their feet. They give Lundqvist an ovation. I mean, all of them in this building, MSG, look at it, they're all standing. And the ovation for Lundqvist, and he has been absolutely terrific, not only tonight, but last night, and the game before that against the Islanders. He's been terrific, and that's a defensive mistake you hate to see your team make in a situation like that.
So three Climber, career shutouts for Lundqvist, Climber, and it's over.
Climber just got behind the defense. Tootin was on that side, and that's a mistake. You just hate to see your team make when everything has gone so well and so positively throughout. I mean, there's a lot of pride in getting the shutout, believe me. Clymer is able to get that shot. Here's the pass by Nicolet, and you can see the left defenseman, and it just goes off the glove and in. But the left defenseman is too. He cheated too far over to the boards. He's got to stay right in the middle of the ice. You stay in the middle of the ice if you're a defenseman, and the play's on the weak side, or even on the strong side, no matter which way they move the puck, you're in a position to defend. When you cheat too far one way or the other, then you leave an opening, and that's what happened.
Yeah, Clymer took advantage quickly.
Good pass by Nicolet.
Yeah, for the Caps' only goal of the game. Peter Pruka had just scored seconds before. He's got 4 career goals in 6 games against the Caps. 6.6 games by Pruka against the Caps. Here they come again. Play broken up by Matt Cullen, sent back to center. Final 2 minutes. Here's Pruka at center, takes a shot.
A penalty coming up now, I believe, or is it just puck? Maybe the puck was hit with a high stick. I think that's what it was.
So just 8 seconds after Pruka scored with 17:23 mark.
There's Clymer, who is known to be more of a good, sound defensive player. Years ago, he was a defenseman. Started this year as a defenseman. He played forward the last 5 years, including the year in Tampa Bay when they won the Stanley Cup.
Yeah, he was part of that championship Stanley Cup team, 2003-2004. Asparitis back behind the net.
Well, they've gotten their money's worth at the Garden tonight, haven't they?
Yes, they have.
And this has been an intense game. Most of it, good, solid hitting by both teams. C- couple of times things got out of hand by both teams.
Well, Brashear was hitting everything in sight most of the way. Finally got a game misconduct. He and Shanahan got matched up in the middle of the garden ice earlier in the period. The Rangers have played a sound game overall. And
well, they have. They played with purpose tonight. I mean, they came out and they played. I keep repeating myself, but it's worth repeating. They played a north-south game.
Exactly.
No turnovers in the neutral zone. Even the big line with Nylander and Jágr. You know what? They swallowed their pride a little bit and said, this is the way we got to play for the team, and it worked.
Hossa gets the return. The shot kicked aside by Kolzig. Bouncing puck. Final 15 seconds. Up the left wing, Aaron Ward does a nice job of breaking the play up. Clymer can't come up with it. Ward ahead, and that will end it. The Rangers skate the final seconds away, and it's over. After 16 days and 7 losses, Tom Rennie and the Rangers back in the win column. The precious 2 points with a 4-1 victory. The first win since the 14th of December at Dallas, the 5-2 victory, and now 4-1 tonight.
Brendan Shanahan still punching. Punch Henrik Lundqvist in the mask. A little love tap is all it was.
And Nylander and Kasparaitis, you know, pumped up.
He led the way, I think, starting with his little speech before the game to the players and what he did on the ice tonight. They had a lot of players step up, and we haven't seen this for a while. It's a good thing right here.
And all around town the last week or so, people wondering, when was the streak going to end? Well, it's over. The Rangers win it 4-1 over the Caps. Brendan Shanahan with a smile. Holwick.
You know what, Mike? There's a lot of young players on this team. A lot of players younger than Brendan Shanahan. It's not to mean that he's old, but he's played a long, long time. They love him. They love being around him. They love talking hockey with him. They love when they work out with him. They love having him around. And they're like little kids. They can't get enough of him. And what a leadership job he's done with this team. What a year he's off to.
And before the game, Shanahan talking briefly to his teammates, saying, forget about what's happened in the past. Let's look ahead. And ahead was 60 minutes of solid hockey and 2 points in the standings, a 4-1 victory. 2 goals by Peter Pruka, 1 by Darius Kasparaitis. 2nd in 7 games for him, 27th of his career, and Michael Nylander had his 13th. The number 3 star, Peter Pruka.
Yeah, good for him. He's a good kid, Peter Pruka, that needs something positive to happen for him. And maybe this will get him going, get him on a roll.
So Pruka's got 8 on the season now. The Oppenheimer Team Contributor Award going to Brendan Shanahan.
Listen,
Oppenheimer funds the right way to invest.
Listen to this.
2 block shots. 1 battle with Donald Brashear.
Something special going on between Brendan Shanahan and the New York fans, isn't there?
And 5 scoring chances and the number 1 star. The goalkeeper, Henrik Lundqvist. 22 saves on the night. Just 1 goal allowed, that coming in the final 3 minutes. And Lundqvist, who had a couple of tough losses recently, with the victory. Now here's Al Trautwig.
All right, Mike, take me inside hockey and explain why what happened had to happen.
I don't know that it had to happen. I just, I thought that Brash kind of taking liberties with Yags most of the night, and we went to the faceoff and asked him if he wanted to go, and I don't know if he thought I was serious, but I asked him again after the puck dropped, and he turned around, and, no problem with him at all. It was my idea. But like I said, I thought he was taking advantage of Yags, and sometimes you just have to make a statement.
All right, here's the conversation that you're having, and at this point, what are you thinking about going one-on-one with him at this point?
Well, obviously, I know he's a heavyweight. You know, I've seen him fight over his career, and seen him beat up a lot of my friends. So no shame in finishing second if you're going against him. But something I still enjoy doing, and I don't get to do it as often as I used to, but It's a great feeling when you're invited.
You know, I spoke to your mom last week, and she said that the only time she was nervous in your career was when you used to fight. Well, here you go again.
Well, you know, I think I've done it my whole career. I've done it every year. Like I said, just doesn't happen in the NHL as much as it used to. And this was a big game. It was a big third period for us. And I think we all made different statements in different ways. And some guys got on the made statements with goals, and other guys made statements in other areas. So we just needed to get a big win, and whatever it took, we had to do.
And then when Colton takes out Ovechkin, that's pretty much saying, you mess with our star, we're going to mess with yours?
Well, no one asked him to do that, you know. I made sure I went to Colton right after my fight with Brashear, and I told him, you know, I'm the one who asked him to go. He didn't corner me into a fight or ask me to fight. I'm the one who went after him. So Colton did what he did, but nobody told him to do it.
What kind of relief is it to finally end the losing?
Oh, it's huge, you know, and we knew we wanted to come out strong, and we did. We got the early goal, and we knew that our fans were frustrated. We were frustrated. We wanted to make sure that they were – we gave them a good reason to get behind us and cheer for us tonight, and we did.
You know, I would think that any Ranger fan who's been a Ranger fan for a while looked at what you did in that third period, and they only thought of one thing, and they thought of Mark Messier. Do you get that sort of sense that they have that relationship with you?
Oh, I would never put my name with his. I mean, Mess has just done something. You know, I'm in my first year here, and, you know, I'm just a 37-year-old guy trying to do as much as I can while I still can, and Mess is a legend. But we all take leadership lessons from great players who played from the Rangers. I take a lot of pride in wearing this uniform. And certainly wasn't happy with losing seven in a row. So, like I said, you know, we talked before the game about scoring goals. I don't care. I was going to say, I don't care if, you know, if Kevin Weeks got the winning goal, as long as we won the game. But it was pretty close. It was Darius Kasparaitis, so pretty close to Kevin Weeks.
Thanks a lot, Brendan.
Okay.
Brendan Shanahan, a star in that third period as the Rangers end the losing with a 4-1 win of the Washington Capitals. Coming up, the latest edition of the 50 Greatest Moments at Madison Square Garden as we wrap things up here on MSG. But the Rangers end the losing streak. We'll take a break. And coming up later tonight, MSG and why. I'm going to be a busy guy now that I think of it.